parole in America. I'm going to talk about the parole system in America, what I think should be changed, what I like, what I don't like about the system, how difficult it is for people to come out of jail, out of prison, and actually turn their lives around, especially if they're struggling with addiction. So, hey guys, I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcad. I'm going to talk about parole in America. Now, parole is obviously a system where if you're serving time in prison, or even if you're not really necessarily serving time in prison, maybe you serve some time in jail, you can qualify for parole. Now, probation, of course, is when you go into the system before you actually serve any time. It's still the result of a conviction. And a lot of these offenders are drug users. They're drug offenders, whether they're involved in trafficking or just possession or whatever. They're involved in the drug trade. So these guys, they get out on parole. Sometimes here in Kentucky, it's MRS, a mandatory release. But you know, they're in a system where they have a parole officer. They have to report to a parole officer. So they get out of jail. Now they need a home placement. They cannot get out of jail or prison and get on parole or anything like that without some type of home placement. Now that's one of the first barriers for a lot of people, because a lot of times these guys, when they're struggling with addiction, they burn so many bridges with their family and friends. A lot of people don't want them coming to their house. A lot of these folks don't have a place to live. They don't own property, and if they own something, they had something, they lost it, because a lot of people, and they're involved in drugs, they go to jail. not only do they learn that their drug friends don't give a damn about them, they also find out that a lot of their associates or neighbors or whatever break into their house and steal everything that they have. Even family. I mean, that's a big thing. Family. I've heard so many stories. Just so you know, I worked as a drug counselor and also as a case manager for rehab. Also, I worked in a offender reentry program. I worked in some places in this field for the last 5 years or so. And I've interacted with and helped so many clients. I've been disappointed by decisions that some of them have made, a lot of them have made, but hey, that's where my experience is coming from, so that's my perspective. Look, the first barrier, okay, you gotta find a home placement. A lot of people won't let you go to their house, even family and friends. A lot of times your family and friends, especially the family of these people coming out of jail, they're actually struggling with addiction. So the parole officers, they actually go to the house when you put in a home placement, say you have a house or something. Parole officers go there, they check out the place, and if it's drug activities, if it's unsafe, if it's something they don't like, it gets denied, okay? There's a lot of rules. For example, if somebody owns a gun and they live there, you can't be there, okay? Even if they have a gun safe and they don't have access, the person coming out of jail, going on parole, doesn't have access to it, they can't do it. They can't live there, okay? There was a situation where somebody, not even a parolee, but the person, a family member of a parolee, actually shot a parole officer here in Kentucky. But anyway, so that's a rule. And the rules vary from state to state, but generally speaking, you can't really do that. They're pretty restrictive on where you can really go. So it's basically a home, which is not an option for a lot of these guys. Second option is basically some type of program, some type of rehab. Halfway house, something like that. A lot of these people are ordering, especially here in Kentucky, to go into some type of halfway house, because in this state, they do their best to try to offer treatment. And you know, if somebody's really looking for treatment, they can get it here, okay? Here in Kentucky, they're really big on that. So that's an option for a lot of people. So halfway houses, home, even a shelter, that could be, but it has to be approved by DOC in that particular state. So that's that can become a huge barrier for a lot of these guys. They get out on parole. They're not just out on parole and expected to get a job. It's hard enough. That's a big barrier for a lot of people, finding a job. But I will say this about Pike County. There are some opportunities to get some type of job. They may not pay the best, especially in restaurants, but it's an opportunity. If you work your ass off, you have opportunity to go up and actually get management opportunities. Let me tell you something. I've helped people get jobs, and I've seen people come right out of prison, okay, and actually get managerial positions. I'm talking assistant manager, store manager, general manager within 6 months. 6 months, okay? I've seen people do amazing things on parole. You know, a lot of people say, oh, well, it's so hard, you gotta pay, and it is hard, because there's a lot of other things they gotta deal with. They gotta pay parole fees, so basically the drug testing fees, things like that. They gotta pay for that stuff, okay? Another thing, supervision fees. Their supervision fee, that's something they gotta pay for. Another thing, restitution. If they harm somebody or they stole something from somebody, they gotta pay a lot of that stuff back. So they may come out of jail and owe a couple $1,000s or $10,000. I've seen bigger numbers, $10,000 or whatever in restitution fees. They gotta pay that stuff back. Fines or whatever, they gotta pay that stuff back. Driver's license. It's hard to get a driver's license when you gotta pay back $500 in fines. Driving without a license, they come out of jail. They have their license suspended. A lot of these guys got to take a DUI class. That stuff isn't free, okay? That's not free at all. They got to pay for that stuff. So you got to get a job and then start paying off that stuff so you can actually get your license, right? And another thing, here's the deal. While you're doing all that, a lot of people don't want to hire you, but again, you know, a lot of it has to do with attitude. I will say that. Because a lot of people, they have an attitude, well, I'm a convicted felon, they won't hire me. Well, it's going to be harder, yeah. So a lot of people won't hire you because you're a convicted felon, but the biggest thing is attitude, okay? The attitude about the situation. If you have attitude, I'm going to find a damn job. I don't care if I get a 100 no's. I'm going to go for 101. Okay, I'm going to keep going until I get a job. Look at it this way. You know, yes, it's going to be harder, but, you know, if you're trying to hook up with a woman and you get rejected by a woman, then rejected by another woman, yeah, you can just say, oh, man, women don't like me. I give up. I quit. Or you can just keep going. You know, improve your game, improve yourself, and keep trying. Don't give up until you find a woman who is interested in you, okay? You know, a closed mouth don't get fed. Keep that in mind. But anyway, going back to parole, yeah, a lot of people, attitude, that's a huge thing. I see a lot of people on parole, and the biggest thing, it really is attitude. What's going on up in here? You know, they can talk about all the barriers, and there are barriers. I'm talking about them right now, but, you know, I've seen people with large fees they gotta pay for this county and this county to get their license back, but they do it. And in rural areas, you gotta have a driver's license, okay? Because the resources are so spread out. You're gonna be living kind of far away from where you're gonna be working. And so in a rural area, you will need a driver's license at some point. In the meanwhile, you gotta walk to work. And I've seen so many people do it. I've seen, I can't even say some of the things I've seen. People, they're actually directors of other programs. Less than a year of being out of jail. Okay, I've seen people do amazing things. You know, this one guy, I'll leave it at that. I've seen people become store managers, okay? Now, I've also seen people screw up opportunities after coming out of parole, coming out of jail and going on parole. But yeah, if you work your butt off, you'll be surprised how quickly, you'll be surprised by how quickly they could actually rise up. But anyway, there are some significant barriers, just like I sort of highlighted right there. These are some big barriers, and a lot of these people, they struggle with addiction. That's one of the biggest barriers. You come out of jail, you know, you either go back to your old county, your old small town, where everybody knows you, and you have this reputation as being a person who's involved in drugs and doing some negative stuff, stealing or whatever, and there's another option to maybe go to a shelter, go to a program, maybe go to a rehab or whatever, halfway house somewhere else. It's scary going away from your home. I know, I'm from Michigan. I came down here to Kentucky, 500 miles or 450 miles away from home, from Flint, Michigan to Eastern Kentucky. Didn't know anybody down here. I came down here to work as a case manager in the rehab, and I did that, and I didn't know anybody here. It's just crazy and scary, but hey, I wanted to do something. I had to make a big move in my life. And so I can relate to people who decide, okay, I'm not going home to my family, my old friends. And I want to go somewhere else and try to get on my feet and try to rebuild a life. And that's an option for people on parole. There's some programs out there, but you got to be willing to take a chance, and you got to have attitude, man. You know, you're going to have some bad days. You're going to have some days where you want to go home, you want to quit. I know I did. I never struggled with addiction or anything like that, but I mean, just simply being away from home, that was a big barrier for me, big challenge for me alone. So the parole system, you know, I understand why they have fees, supervision fees and things like that, because, you know, they have expenses here, okay? They have expenses for these programs. And it varies from state to state. Some states, you know, it's sort of lean towards more like almost like law enforcement. You know, our goal is to keep, parole is always to keep the community safe. But some places, you know, some states, they sort of lean more towards, okay, let's help these guys. Let's help them find jobs. And it's generally what they try to do in parole. That's what they try to do generally. certain states encourage that more. And I gotta tell you, I've seen parole officers work really hard to help people. Federal parole officers, state parole officers, really hard to help people. I mean, I know I have. Let me tell you, people are given chances. It varies from state to state. Some states, you know, they don't play around. You do one little thing wrong, and it's you go back to prison. Not that going to prison is funny, but anyway. But in certain states, in Kentucky, they'll try to help you, man. But yes, there's barriers. There's the system is definitely imperfect, but you know, you can't make somebody want to go to the point where you can't make somebody want to stop using drugs. You can't make somebody become sober. You know, you can't make them. It's a decision that we all have to make as human beings, whether we want to do something or not. And when it comes to, and at least half of the people in jail, they are drug users. They are drug offenders. They have addiction. They're struggling with addiction. And it's difficult to leave your family and friends and everything that you know. You're not just leaving drugs. You're leaving a lifestyle. You're leaving everything that you know. And it's hard, it plays tricks on your mind, but so a lot of people, they gotta get to that point. You know, a lot of times around here, people, they don't really get to that point until they're deep in their 30s and 40s. Some people still don't get to that point where they say, hey, I'm sick of this mess. So parole, what would I like to see change in the parole system? I'd like to see more programs and resources offered to people who are serious about recovery. You know, because to me, I know there's a lot offered to everybody in general because there's this, you know, there's so many people in the system. You want to cycle through. But I wish and it's not just a parole system. I just wish we were able to offer more resources for people who, and there is a lot, but I just think we should focus even more on programs for people who are coming out and really people who really want to make that change. You know, if you're not serious about that, serious about making change, I don't think money should be wasted on you. I feel the same way about schools. You know, if you don't want to really want to learn, I don't think we should be wasting money on you. We shouldn't be putting you in the same classroom as a kid who actually wants to learn. Anyway, that's just my opinion. Anyway, guys, share your thoughts on the parole system in America and the parole system in your country, wherever you happen to be. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And I guess the question of the day is, how do you feel about the parole system? Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.